Hurricane Ian altered our coastline. Most of our beaches are unrecognizable, and health officials are urging everyone to stay off the sand and out of the water. Today, crews on Marco Island started to replenish some of the beaches to prevent erosion. We are local tonight on the island with NBC2's Ryan Arbogast.
There's a lot of things this little sandbar does for Marco Island. It's a nature sanctuary, and it helps protect us from storms. Now, millions of dollars are on their way to save it, but we don't have much time.
The pacer was eroding 50 feet per year to a level where at some point you'll have to resort to hardening your shoreline, which is totally unnatural.
Sand Dollar Isle off the coast of Hideaway Beach in Marco Island is disappearing, and Irma and Ian haven't helped.
This area lost, I believe, between 15 and 20 acres of wetlands since Hurricane Irma, and we will restore a big part of that. Wetlands is a very valuable habitat.
The nature sanctuary is home to hundreds of seabirds. To save it from falling into the Gulf, construction crews are now starting to reverse the erosion process, moving sand from one coast to another.
The project is estimated to move over 400,000 cubic yards of sand.
More than $3 million from the city of Marco Island is being used to repeat this process every 3 to 5 years. But crews have to move quickly.
It's timed to allow construction to occur outside of active nesting season for sea turtles and bird nesting season.
This is just the beginning. Construction is slated to begin as soon as Wednesday. And you can see barges have already come in. Expect more heavy machinery here for the next 6 months. I'm reporting local today at Hideaway Beach on Marco Island. Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.